how you feel right now, obviously, not making the finals?
Pretty upset, because I feel like I'm in the best shape of my life right now. So I think I missed a very good opportunity to make the final. I think this is the steepest field it'll be in a while. So it'll only get harder from here. You know, it's a very young 800-meter field. We got Bet, we got Amos is young, Korea's young, Clayton's not even here, Boris is young. All the U.S. guys are young. It's only going to get harder from here, so I just got to be better.
Yeah, I mean, do you feel like you made any mistakes tonight?
I judged myself right. I didn't want to go any faster than 24 or 25 out. They went about 23, 24 out, so they just beat me the first 200, and they held me the rest of the race. No, I don't think we went out too hard. You never go out too hard. I don't think we went out too hard at all, but I didn't race right. I ran bad and I paid the price for it. Now I just lost my opportunity at making the finals and getting a medal for the United States.
And do you feel like if you won lost on that final turn, you feel like if you found somewhere you would have been okay?
I'm not gonna make excuses. That's what happened, you know. Maybe I would have done better, maybe I wouldn't have, I'm not sure.
So I mean, looking at the season of Hollis, is there anything you would change? Do you feel pretty good about how the whole year went?
I feel pretty good about how the whole year went. I still got a couple more races probably. Yeah. Maybe like try to get myself in a mile if I can get in one. But right now I just want to pay off to a hotel and rethink about what just happened.
Have you ever broken four? Is that a goal?
I mean, that's not really something I set out to be. I'm a 100-meter runner. I just train for the 8. The miles are something I do for fun.
Because you're so young, do you feel like a little bit of encouragement? Like, okay,
age isn't really a fact, you know? Yeah, this isn't. I'm not gonna say come funny, that's why I didn't. Lack of experience is why I made it. It just didn't make it. I didn't run right. Career's 22 years old. Bet's 19 or 20 years old. We just won. So age really isn't something that's gonna make or break somebody.
What'd you learn from this meet?
Take it race by race. I saw the two races before me. I saw career might not be in the final. I saw McBride went on 50 and came back with a 145. If I go on 50, I think I could come back 143, 144. So I was just thinking about Tuesday's race instead of tonight's race, and that's why I paid the ultimate price.
Yeah.
What do you mean by what? I was just thinking ahead. Yeah, I was thinking we might have just knocked some of the best guys like Kuro out, so I was thinking this might even a better chance for me to get in. But I had to obviously qualify for tonight. I didn't do that, so it doesn't really matter now. I don't know. Like I just said, I think I tried judging myself right, and I think I went out what I wanted to do, and it just so happened that my pace that I went out in wasn't the pace they wanted to go out in. So it's just what happened. If I was in a different heat, maybe things would have been differently, but it's what happened, and I can't change anything.
Is there anything you're still looking to improve on? Like, what do you feel like you're
doing? I mean, you can improve on anything, you know, my strength, my speed, my everything. 800 meters is a hard race to coach. Coach Francis does a very well job with all of my athletes, and Coach Henry at A&M, so I'm thankful. I believe I'm the best training coach in the world. I got Coach Francis, I got Coach Henry, I got all the A&M supporting me. And I think there's no better place to train and be a great 400-meter runner.
Yeah, I mean, you got a great coach for him. What makes him such a good coach?
Just something about him, you know? Yeah, you can't explain greatness, and that's what Coach Henry and Coach Francis are. I'm going to go find out.
Thank you for the time.